Well, the FALCON trial is the first and the only phase 3 trial that directly compares ponatinib versus imatinib combined with reduced intensity chemotherapy in newly diagnosed patients with Ph-positive ALL. So it's clear that we need phase 3 trials, and this is the only and the important clinical trial in this setting. The design of the study is a randomized study, phase 2-to-1 randomization, that including in the experimental arm, ponatinib at a dose of 30 milligrams day, and combined with vincristine steroids after induction, methotrexate and cytarabine in consolidation, and then reinductions again with vincristine and steroids, and finally continuation therapy with ponatinib. The standard, the control arm, is imatinib with the same chemotherapy, and imatinib at a standard dose of 600 milligrams day. The primary endpoint is to assess MRD-negative status at complete response if there is an improvement in the experimental arm. And this main objective has been reached because MRD negative in the experimental arm is more than 30% versus less than 20% in the imatinib arm. So the difference is statistically significant, and this is the primary endpoint. The secondary endpoint is event-free survival, and this has not been reached yet, but when the first analysis has been done, the follow-up is still too short to demonstrate any benefit in the experimental arm. We have to wait for a new analysis with a longer follow-up. Well, this is an important clinical significance because ponatinib is the most powerful TKI inhibitor for treatment of patients with Ph-positive ALL. And the importance of the results are summarized that this ponatinib has been approved by the FDA with the results of this phase 3 study, the FALCON study. So I think that in the near future, we will use ponatinib as the only TKI to be combined with chemotherapy or immunotherapy for treatment of newly diagnosed adult patients with Ph-positive ALL. The next for this study is really to demonstrate that this initial advantage translates into significant improvement is the event-free survival. And I think, as we demonstrate in the present study to be presented at this IHA meeting, really that the number of stem cell transplantations has been reduced, are reduced in the ponatinib arm. The benefit of ponatinib is seen across all the ages and across all the subtypes, the two subtypes of Ph-positive ALL. So the advantage on ponatinib is achieved in any subtype or subgroup of Ph-positive ALL. So it's an important message, and we think that we will use ponatinib in the near future as first-line therapy.